Black vote in 1984, Donahue at 3.
This is Fantasy, the show where dreams really do come true. And here to make them happen, our fantasy team, Peter Marshall.
Hello.
Leslie Uggams.
Hi.
And Glenn Scarpelli.
Back again, pal. Good to see you all.
Yeah.
Woo! What a great audience.
Yeah.
What a nice audience. Well, now, this is our Father's Day show, so they said I could go cash. You're very cash.
I'm as cash as it gets.
I'm collegiate.
You certainly are.
But you look very nice.
Thank you.
We welcome everybody to our show and to our Father's Day special as we honor a man who, despite his own disabilities, wins awards for service to others.
Four-time dad, two-time stepdad, and three-and-a-half-time grandpa. My love, Peter Marshall, steps into the spotlight with a song for dads everywhere.
You betcha.
That's great. We'll see the results of our makeover efforts as Tom Rowley from Chips presents not only the three volunteers, but the latest in men's fashions.
And we'll announce the third weekly winner of our Have a Fantasy game.
And you'll come with us as Glenn and I salute the father at the request of his 12-year-old son. And this being the eve of Father's Day weekend, what better way to start it all off than with a young boy's fantasy for his father? It began with a letter from a 12-year-old. I believe he lives in Sacramento, California. He mentioned several fantasies, but we'll have him tell all about it himself. Seth Boyle, he's right down here. Come on with it, Seth.
Okay.
Seth, would you step over to the aisle?
Come on over here, Seth.
Nice to see you, son. May I shake your hand?
Welcome, Seth. And this must be, now where's your mom and dad?
Right.
That must be your mom and dad, right? Now, you wrote to us about them, right? Well, welcome the both of you. Now, you wrote a pretty terrific letter, and the best paragraph of all is where you said, I know my whole family would share in this fantasy because of the love and support we showed towards one another. Is that really true?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You had a couple of fantasies in mind, didn't you?
Yeah.
One for your brother, and I believe two for your father. Tell us about them.
My brother's graduating from high school June 4th, and I wanted some money for his graduation.
Well, that's past,
that's
but
neat.
That's all right, uh-huh.
And my dad has real bad backaches, and he.
You didn't cause them, did you?
No.
Maybe the headaches.
I wanted to clarify that.
And he went to our neighbors, and they had an inversion board, and they said he could try one out, and he got on it, and it helped his back.
Oh, that lean inversion?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, it really helped your daddy then.
Yeah.
And what else? You had two.
And my dad spent 2.5 years refinishing a concert grand piano for our church, and a lady in our church gave my dad a baby grand piano for him to refinish.
Oh. So you would need some lacquer?
Some money for lacquer.
How much is lacquer?
It's $80 for a gallon.
$80.
That's a lot for lacquer, my God.
Well, that Mr. Steinway must be doing very well. And Mr. Baldwin, all those guys.
I'll tell you, Seth, we thought it might be fun for you to make those fantasies come true all by yourself. Do you know about the fantasy fountain?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, I'll tell you something. By your parents' permission, of course, we're going to send you backstage to get ready, and then we're going to send you in the fantasy fountain and see how much money you can grab. How's that sound to you?
Fine.
Yeah, sounds great. We're going to do that in just
a minute. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Boy, you have an extraordinary son here, and I'm sure that he will grab a bundle. So, if you'll go right backstage and get dressed,
I'll
we'll join Seth.
Okay.
Yes, you go with him, all right? In the meantime, let's go to find out what Leslie Uggams is up to. Leslie?
I'm here with Bill Rail, who we flew in today to meet the son that he's never met. And what better day than Father's Day weekend to have such a reunion. Bill, first of all, where are you from?
Fort Wayne, Indiana.
And what do you do?
I'm a letter carrier for the United States Postal Service.
Now, I understand that you have a rather large family now. Tell us about them.
Yes, we have 11 children at home. Our oldest son is 18 years old, and our youngest son is a year and a half.
And you live on a farm, is it?
11 acres, yes.
That's terrific. Now, on top of all that responsibility, you just graduated from college. Congratulations. Isn't that terrific? What degree did you earn?
I earned a bachelor's degree of business administration from St. Francis College in Fort Wayne.
I think that's sensational that you went back to school and got your degree. That's
Thank
sensational.
You very much.
Now, it sounds like you really got your life together, but when you were a little younger, that necessarily wasn't the case, was it?
No, it wasn't.
You want to tell us a little bit about how the separation happened between you and your son?
I married at the age of 18 and was very immature and too young to take on the responsibility that I did. Mm-hmm. And My son's mother had a daughter, age 3, I believe, and I was too immature to take on the responsibility of fatherhood and yes. and to be a husband, too.
And you went into the service, I understand.
Too. Yes. Just after Jim was born, I went into the Army and was in the Army for 3 years.
And then when you came out, you and she separated.
We separated prior to that, prior to going in the service. I went into mm-hmm. the service after the separation.
And you lost contact with the son?
Yes, I did.
Let me ask you, were you looking for your son all the time? I mean, what prevented the two of you really from seeing each other?
Well, there was a lot of bitterness on her part, and a lot of it was well-founded. And, mm-hmm. I tried for several years to contact my son.
Now, Bill, there was no, well, there'll be no obstacles, obviously, in the way of this reunion. Well, as you know, we've brought your son, Jim, into the studio today under a different pretext than he imagines. And in just a few minutes, we're going to bring him out. So, and I'm going to talk to him a little bit and then give both of you this special treat for Father's Day.
Thank you very much.
In the meantime, here's the girls from Facts of Life, Nancy McKeon, Tim Fields, and Mindy Cohn.
From pianos to living room furniture to animals to you name it, we delivered it.
One of the most unique fantasies the truck can bring to anyone is a loved one he or she hasn't seen in years.
We heard from Michelle Hairgrove of Waxahachie, Texas, a city just outside of Dallas, whose fantasy was to see her best friend, Joy Carruthers, whom she met when both were counselors at a summer camp 7 years ago.
As Michelle wrote in her letter, a good friend is hard to find. So we sent our good friend, Chris Lemon, in the fantasy truck to bring together, once again, two best buddies.
We made it, Joy. Hop on out. Chris, why don't you take the truck around the corner, buddy? Well, hello there. We are in beautiful downtown Waxahachie, Texas, and with me is Joy Carruthers. And we're about to go and surprise a friend of yours you haven't seen in about 7 years, isn't that right?
7 years. I can't wait to see her.
You must be a little excited.
I'm very excited.
Well, I tell you what, why don't we get on over there and give her the surprise of her life?
Let's go.
All right. Hi there, Michelle.
What is going on?
Well, come on in and you'll find out.
Wait a minute.
Come on. He knows, too. Come on in here, Michelle. Oh, look at you. You've been at the beach, haven't you?
Oh, yeah.
My goodness, this is your husband back there. How are you? And your beautiful baby boy, who I'm going to ask him to hold on for 2 seconds, and I'm going to whisk you in here and tell you exactly why your curtains are closed.
Oh,
you ever heard of a show called Fantasy?
Yeah.
Well, my name is Chris Lemon, and I'm from that show, and you wrote us a letter a little while ago, didn't you?
So did about a million other people.
Yes, but your letter is the one that we're concerned about. What did you say in that letter? Do you remember?
I think so.
It had to do with a reunion, I think, didn't it?
Yeah.
A little something? Come on, tell me what you said.
Well, I just want to see a friend named Joy.
Joy?
Uh-huh, Joy Carruthers.
Joy Carruthers. Where does she live right? Where are you going?
Oh, I'm putting this down.
Okay, that's all right.
Well,
where does she live right now?
Well, she lives in Hemet.
In Hemet? Where's that?
California.
In California? Oh, really? That's where we live, too. How long has it been since you've seen her?
Oh, a long time.
Yeah, what, about 7 years or so?
Oh, about six.
About 6 years, right around in there. And how did you guys meet?
Well, we were at a youth camp, and mm-hmm. we counseled together.
And evidently you became pretty close
mm-hmm.
friends, right? Now, didn't you guys sort of exchange gifts when you had to leave each other at the camp?
Yeah, I gave her a T-shirt, and she gave me a pillowcase.
She gave you a pillowcase?
Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you, I'm going to digress for 1 second here. I want you to look at a picture. See that picture right there? Do you recognize anybody in there?
Well, that's George, Joy. It's me, about 50 pounds heavier.
Let me ask you, did the pillowcase look anything like...
That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
And what did you give her?
A green shirt that said nowhere else but Corpus Christi.
That said... You gave her a green shirt that said nowhere else but Corpus Christi.
Right.
Did it look anything like...
Oh, my
that?
God! Oh, I can't believe it. Oh, I can't believe it. Oh, I'm so good to see you.
Can you believe this? Surprise, lady.
I wouldn't have gotten sunburned.
I think it's just great that they have a show on TV that they can reunite people and make people so happy. I think it's just fantastic.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Chris, for making that Friends fantasy come true. Stay tuned, because all next week on Fantasy, the Chuck will be bringing a lot more of the same and a lot more of the unusual.
And coming up, a father of hundreds.
Bill meets the son he's never seen.
And Tom Riley is here in person.
With the results of his makeover.
What's the watchword for antacids?
Watch your salt!
Right. The Surgeon General's report says Americans get too much salt. So when you need an antacid, reach for Ryapan Plus, the fast-acting antacid low in sodium. So low, it's considered sodium-free. Laboratory tests show Ryapan Plus worked 4 times faster than the 2 leading liquids. Ryapan Plus, fast-acting, low in sodium. So low, it's considered sodium-free. Ryapan Plus.
With some contests, you have to wait so long to find out if you won, you wonder whether anyone even won at all. Well, at Publishers Clearing House, we tell you who wins top prizes 4 times a year on TV. Find out who wins $100,000, $125,000, who wins $365,000.
And our grand prize winner is...
So watch your mail for the Publishers Clearing House $2 million sweepstakes and enter. When it comes to winning, there's no place like our house.
Recognize her? She's the fresh-dressed woman. What's her secret?
For one thing, I slip into freshness every day with Carefree Panty Shields. Such a nice way to feel extra fresh all the time. Carefree Panty Shields are so dainty and comfortable, I make them part of getting dressed every day.
What's the secret of the fresh-dressed woman?
I slip into freshness every day with Carefree Panty Shields.
And now they're completely new. You'll love the petal plush softness.
I always try to do the best I can for my family, and that includes using a pain reliever I can really trust. For many years, we've taken Tylenol. I discovered Tylenol in the hospital when I had my second child. It worked then, and I've used it ever since. Turns out Tylenol is the pain reliever hospitals use most, and that's been so for more than 10 years. Well, if hospitals trust Tylenol, that confirms my own trust.
For relief you can trust, trust Tylenol. Hospitals do. Tylenol. Safety sealed for your protection.
You know, Fantasy is receiving thousands of letters a week, so it's not surprising that 10-year-old Lloyd Keller III of Philadelphia writes, "This is my 5th letter I wrote to you, and I'm not giving up." Lloyd wants a microwave oven for his dad, who has single-handedly been raising him since his mother left 7 years ago. Lloyd Jr. is looking for work and pushing his son to do well at school. 10-year-old Lloyd III says, "My dad is the greatest, and he's trying his best. See, Dad's on my tail about school, and I see why. You have to be skillful and smart to get a job out there. My report card has 11 A's and 2 B's. That's not bad. And I'm glad Dad's pushing me about school. Lloyd, it sounds to me that you've got a very caring dad, and we'd like to make, you know, to show your appreciation. So here comes a fantasygram to Lloyd Keller III, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Get ready for a big Father's Day at your house, because on its way to you is Tappan's Deluxe Microwave Oven with tap-and-touch controls for fast cooking at your fingertips and an automatic temperature probe so you can cook with either time or temperature furnished by Tappan. Hope you both keep up the good work. Sincerely, Glenn and the gang at Fantasy. Leslie, where are you?
I'm here.
There you are.
This being the last show before Father's Day weekend, we decided to invite a young man who wrote us about his lifelong search for his natural father. There has been some success in that search, and to tell us a little more about this story, would you please help me welcome, from Salt Lake City, Utah, Jim Bueller. Hi, Jim.
Hi.
How old are you?
24.
Now, what do you do?
I'm a carpenter.
And have you ever seen your natural father?
No, I haven't.
Can you explain why?
Well, when I was about 2 weeks old, my parents got divorced. And then in between the years, we moved from Florida to Utah. And I guess we just got lost.
Mm-hmm. When did you know that your natural father existed?
When I was about 10 or 11.
Now, I know something happened last summer that truly changed your outlook on finding your father. Can you explain that to us?
Yes, my grandfather called my parents. And He told me that my father was trying to get a hold of me. So I contacted my father, my grandfather in Florida, asked him for his number, and he never left us. So I started doing some research. And then a month later, I found the phone number.
And you spoke with him?
Yeah.
How was that phone call for you?
It was scary.
I bet. Now, do you and your dad have some plans maybe to get together and meet each other?
Yeah, in about 2 weeks.
That's terrific.
Yeah.
Jim, we're going to change those plans a little bit, though. I don't think you're going to mind, however. Happy Father's Day, Jim. I want you to look over there. I'm going to take you by the hand because I want you to meet your father, Bill Rail. Separate you two because it's been too long since you've been away from each other. You like this Father's Day gift?
Yeah.
I'm happy for you, and we're glad that the two of you have been brought together again. And I want to wish you a truly happy Father's Day and enjoy each other on behalf of Fantasy.
Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations.
Coming up, Tom Riley returns in person with our three completely made over young men featuring the latest in fashion of the season. And don't forget, today we announce the third winner of our Have a Fantasy game.
Only one dressing can wear this label. Introducing Philadelphia brand dressings. Get into the thick of it. Get into all your favorite flavors, perfectly blended with real Philadelphia brand cream cheese. For a new line of dressings so thick, they cling to your salad. Get into the only dressings made with Philadelphia brand cream cheese. Get into the thick of it.
Now Lysol has a pine cleaner with a pine trio of cleaners in every bottle.
And we're the Lysol Pine Trio.
We clean
to cut through dirt and grease.
Disinfect to kill household germs.
Deodorize with a fresh, clean scent.
Now there's a Lysol cleaner with the action of pine. New Lysol Pine Action Cleaner.
A pine trio of cleaners in new Lysol Pine Action.
Superman peanut butter?
Superman, our brand's pine.
Have you ever tasted Superman peanut butter?
Well, no. It smells like fresh roasted peanuts. Delicious, rich and creamy.
That's its strength. It's great taste. Nutritious too.
Wow! Good housekeeping seal. Impressive.
Wow.
That did taste good.
Get a free Superman 3 movie poster from Superman peanut butter. Details in Sunday papers on June 19th.
For a brand new Lipton iced tea, here's Chris Everett Lloyd.
You know, the hardest part of playing tennis is getting in shape to play. And part of that is watching what I eat and drink. That's why I love this new Lipton iced tea mix. No sugar, no saccharin. It's got NutraSweet. NutraSweet has a natural taste of sugar, but it's not an artificial sweetener like saccharin. It's my favorite part of staying fit.
New Lipton iced tea mix. No sugar, no saccharin.
You'll love the goodness and the taste.
A vacation in paradise suddenly becomes a fight for survival. Trapped underground with a mad killer. Cave-in. Their lives are hanging by a thread. Sunday.
If you'd like to send us your fantasy, write down all the information in a letter, enclose a picture we can keep, and your phone number. Mail it to Fantasy, Post Office Box 99, Hollywood, California 90028.
This week started out with three young guys whose fantasy was to have a complete makeover for summer. And with the help of Tom Riley of Chips, Fantasy sent them to a makeover laboratory at the beach. Here to tell us all about it is Tom Riley.
Let's go.
Okay. We've been watching your segment at the beach, and the guys too, all week, but we haven't seen the finished products yet. Are there any dramatic changes?
Wait till you see. When you see these guys, ladies, watch out. Really, watch out.
Okay.
Now, today is the last part of the makeover, and we'll see what different clothing styles you helped out with the guys. So I guess we're all anxious to meet them, all of them. First is 25-year-old Mark Nearing, right?
That's right.
Let's see what he looked like to start out with. Okay, that's him before.
Now, Mark told us he wanted to lighten his hair, and he works in a fitness center and wanted to improve his general appearance.
Let's see the new Mark.
Hey! Hey.
Before we worked with Mark, Mark was only 95 pounds.
So. let me ask you something. How do you feel after your week-long makeover or whatever?
I feel great.
Yeah?
Really good.
Yeah?
Good.
Improved?
It was fun.
You like the new look, or did you like the way you looked before?
I like the new look.
You like the new look?
Okay, let's
look great.
He does look great. Fantastic.
Okay. Next we'll meet Daniel Winter, a 25-year-old Englishman who now lives in Venice, California. This is what he looked like before.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now Daniel wanted to get out of his jeans and t-shirts, but not into ties and jackets. He wants a more casual lifestyle, which our makeover reflects. We just made him a little less wild.
Let's see what he looks like now.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. Great. Oh, Dan.
How you doing? Your hair looks a little shorter, and your clothing is a lot different. How do you like the way you look now?
I feel great.
Yeah?
Just hope it works, okay?
Okay. That's good.
Hey,
wait.
Okay.
From my mother. Very good, Dan.
Very good.
What do you think your girlfriend will think of your new makeover?
We're going to find out when I go home tonight.
Okay. Oh, good luck.
Danny was from Brooklyn, and he also wanted a speech changed.
I did, Tom.
Okay, now, finally, our most dramatic makeover of all, Danny Cross. Now, Danny is 22 and works for a construction company, but he told us he was thinking about a job change. Right.
So? Most people want a more clean-cut look for when they job hunt.
Well, it's best to see for yourself. So here is the new, well, that's the old Danny Cross. Now here is the new Danny Cross.
Woo!
Awesome.
All right.
Quite a dramatic change. What do you think about it?
I'm still getting used to it myself.
what happened when you went home? When you went home after it was all done with?
It was awesome.
Did anybody recognize you or?
No. I went by to see my grandmother and she wouldn't. She was looking through the window. She couldn't figure out who it was.
Just don't bit him.
Oh, no. Now, I want to tell you, by the way, the outfits that you guys are wearing are furnished by Fila, an international line of leisure wear seen throughout the sports world, furnished by Fila, and they're yours to keep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. And thank you, my buddy, for helping us make this fantasy come true. You all look great.
Yeah.
And hope to see you around the beaches this summer.
Peter. What do you think, girls? What do you think?
Yeah. All right.
Very impressive. Very impressive. I'm standing here with the Boyle family, not the entire family. Mr. Boyle, I believe there are seven?
Seven in our family, yes.
And you brought everybody here today except the baby and the five-year-old, and you're taking advantage of Southern California. You're going to go to all the different parks and things. Right. But the main reason we are here is because of Seth here. Seth wanted a fantasy for his dad for Father's Day, an inversion board, and maybe some cash for the lacquer for the grand piano. $80 a gallon. I never knew that. Are you ready to do it?
Yeah.
You know the rules?
Yeah.
He says, I come home from school and I watch fantasy. I never figured I'd be here. And here you are, boy. You get in there, but don't bend down and pick it up. Yeah. Okay, you can grab it off the walls, though. Don't tell anybody. We only count the money in the pouch there. Good luck, son. Don't start grabbing until I give you the signal. All right, Seth, get in there. I'm going to open the door. Stand in the center where we have the space for you. And just good luck, son. Let's see how much you can get for your mom, for your dad, for Daddy's Day. Watch me. Let's start the blower. And go! Grab it. Oh, that's it. You got to grab it off. Hey, get off the wall, Seth. Come on. Seth, let's start the blower. So, Seth, look over there. Seth, there's a whole glob of it coming up. Seth, grab it off the wall. That's it. That's it. Grab it. Yep. Righty, okay. That's okay. Yeah, that's
good. Earl's not here, is he?
Our producer's on vacation. Well, the heck with it. He got a late start. Well, so did I. If the truth were known. Anyway, what we're going to do here, I think you did pretty well. We're going to add it all up. We're going to give the officials a chance to count up the loot for Dad, and then we'll be back and continue with fantasy.
Some members of our studio audience and some fantasy participants will receive this tote bag from Pan Am, the first airline in the world, serving 38 countries. Pan Am brings new meaning to the word experience, and when it comes to flying, you can't beat the experience. A handsome gents quartz analog day-date watch in a round carrot-clad case with matching adjustable micron bracelet, champagne dial, and stainless steel back, furnished by Jules Jurgensen. The Texas Instruments home computer with monitor for education, home finance, and entertainment is not just for playing, it's also for learning. A home computer furnished by Texas Instruments.
Coming up, some kids get the chance to pick a gift for their daddies, and next you'll find out what's set here garnered in the fountain.
New and improved Handy Wrap 2 introduces Cling Plus.
Oh, you ain't got a thing if you ain't got that cling. Durap, durap, durap.
Oh, you ain't got a thing if you ain't got that cling. Durap, 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 durap.
Handy Wrap 2 with Cling Plus has twice as much cling as before, so it seals tighter to seal in freshness and flavor longer.
Oh, you ain't got a thing if you ain't got that cling.
New and improved Handy Wrap 2, it's a must to have that Cling Plus.
Nora Barrett.
Tag.
Oh.
You wouldn't miss our class reunion.
Oh, I wouldn't miss any of your good cooking. Mmm. Your macaroni salad's still so much better than mine.
Well, I'm still using Best Foods Real Mayonnaise.
There's a difference?
Oh, I think so. No other mayonnaise tastes fresher or creamier than Best Foods. It's what I depend on to make all my specialties taste their very best.
Mmm. Best Foods can make a difference.
Best Foods helps make whatever you make the best.
Is that the Publisher's Clearinghouse $2 million sweepstakes you just got?
Mm-hmm.
How come you haven't sent it in?
Contests are just gimmicks.
That's what I used to think. Then my prize doubled to $150,000.
I have to be dumb to enter contests.
That's what I used to think. Now tell me how dumb I am.
You know that Publisher's Clearinghouse $2 million sweepstakes you just got? Why haven't you sent it in? Lots of clearinghouse winners used to think that, too. Come on, send it in.
Can you hear it?
I can hear it.
Can you taste it?
I can taste it.
It's the real grain taste of Jackson. You can hear how hearty it is. Can you hear it?
We can hear it.
Can you taste it?
We can taste it.
It's the real grain taste of Jackson.
Chex brand cereals take the taste of rice, corn, wheat, and bran and gives them real grain crunch.
Can you hear it?
Hey!
It's the real grain taste of Chex. You can hear how hearty it is.
Fantasy will return in a moment.
Tuesday on St. Elsewhere.
Hi there.
A flasher dresses up the hospital. But does everyone enjoy the view?
Oh, for crying out loud.
All Phil and Jim stores are celebrating our biggest grand opening sale ever. Anaheim West, 333 South Euclid, south of Lincoln at Broadway. Big opening, big savings on this Whirlpool four-cycle washer with permanent press and soak cycles and three wash-rinse combinations at $329.86. Or this electric dryer with four drying temperatures and three cycles, including permanent press at $279.86. Now at grand opening prices in all stores. Don't miss it.
When you gotta have a delicious Cheez-It cracker from Sunshine, you gotta have it. And you'll do almost anything to get it. Because Cheez-It crackers are made with real cheese. And Cheez-Its are so crunchy, so munchy, you'll want to eat them by the handful. Cheez-It from Sunshine. When you gotta have it, you gotta have it.
When you gotta have it, you gotta have it.
It's Robinson's summer sale and clearance. You'll save 30% on striped cotton knit shirts with the famous alligator logo. Save 45% on colorful cotton beach towels, just $10.99. Save 42 to 60% and more on feather and down pillows, all sizes, just $19.99. And save 31 to 60% and more on Wamsutta No Iron Percale queen and king size sheets and comforters. The summer sale and clearance happening now at Robinson's.
John DeLorean now claims he was set up by the British. Story at 4.
And now back to fantasy, where dreams do come true.
This is not the Mormon Tabernacle Choir I'm with. No, it's the royal family. We're missing two. The baby. We got Nate the Great here. Hey, Nate, you're on TV. How's it going? Do you know how well your brother did?
Yeah.
Yeah? He did very well. Yes, $1,500. That's yours. Thank you. Happy Father's Day. We've had quite a summer. You betcha.
Next, we have a fantasy for a couple that has been married almost 20 years. Where's Margie and Pete Horner? Where are the Horners?
Where are they?
Hello. Come on out here. Why don't we come down here? I'm going to put you over here next
to
Ben.
Okay, come next to me.
Come on, hubby. You come over here next to me.
Now, Pete, you don't know this, but your wife wrote in to tell us that you're a dad in a million. How many children do you have?
Three
children.
Now, Margie, I understand about 10 years ago, hubby here had a glaucoma attack that left him blind. Tell us about that.
He was blind for about 2 years after he had his glaucoma attack. It was, I believe he was 24 or 26, something like that. But we spent about 2 years with the kids, and he wasn't working, so we spent a lot of time together.
Now, although he could no longer see, he still would help Kelly build model cars. How?
Right. Well, he'd direct Kelly. He'd do a lot of the spray painting, and Kelly would be the one that was doing the putting together of the models, and they just... That's about the way it is.
Follow Dad's instructions. Well, Dad must have given some good instruction. Let me ask you, Pete. Now, you also took the kids bowling, fishing, camping. How in the world could you do all this?
Well, I could just, you know, see enough, you know, to get around and get emulsated, you know, did the rest.
Oh, that's
it. Now, eventually your sight was restored. How many operations did that take?
I believe it took about five.
Now, after all that time, you even kept up with your civic duties. What are some of the activities that you're involved in?
I was involved in JCs. I'm been on city an alderman on the city council, and I belong to the rural fire department.
Wow.
And you did all this in spite of not being able to see?
Well, these are some of the specific ones, you know, that I've been doing right now.
I could see why you were named among the outstanding young men of America, Pete. Now, have you ever had any time, however, to be alone with Margie, you know, like, I don't know, on a honeymoon?
No, not really.
No.
Well, in fact, Pete, Margie says that you had to delay your honeymoon for almost 20 years because of a calamity, one after another. Is that true?
That's true.
Now, one of your delayed honeymoons was canceled after one day. Margie, tell us why you never made it to the Black Hills.
I was pregnant with my daughter, Kim.
Is it true that you kept kind of having some morning sickness?
Yeah.
And what day was the baby born on?
She was born on Father's Day.
Well, that's appropriate. Margie and Pete, we think you both deserve a Father's Day fantasy for all you've been through. It's 20 years late, but we're sending you on a honeymoon to Aruba. Antillian Airlines, for a week stay for two at the Diva Diva Hotel, one of the most intimate and charming in the Caribbean, furnished by Diva Diva Beach Hotel.
And congratulations. Happy Father's Day to you.
Happy
on behalf of Fantasy, thank you for being with us today. Thank you.
Coming up, yours truly with a Father's Day song, and next, some children picking gifts for their dad. And one of you received the third weekly gift in our Have a Fantasy game.
Will Amy's bib ever be this clean again? Watch. I'll cover the original clean with this patch.
Then let her go at it. What a mess. Oh, no. Those are tough stains. Now I'll use Spray and Wash. It's specially formulated to break up tough stains. The results? Look, my Spray and Wash brought Amy's bib back to the original clean.
Get your family's clothes back to the original clean. Get Spray and Wash.
Oh, my cooked ham has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R. And it also has a last name, M-A-Y-E-R. With a taste like this, it has to be my favorite cold cut specialty. 'Cause its middle name is plain to see, 95% fat-free.
Oscar Mayer cooked ham, 95% fat-free, 100% delicious. Ever wonder what Oscar Mayer has in store for you?
JCPenney, USA, this week's buying guide to our Father's Day sale with gifts for all kinds of dads. A dress shirt sale for the debonair dad. And all Comfort Plus shoes on sale, too.
For active dads, famous name shirts and Nike and Adidas footwear on sale. For sporty dads, the Fox, Hunt Club, and Par 4s on sale. Dad has his day in JCPenney, USA, at JCPenney now.
Meet the Blavises, Publishers Clearinghouse double prize winners.
Our $75,000 prize doubled to $150,000, like that.
The best thing that ever happened to us happened twice.
With a Publishers Clearinghouse double prize stamp, winning feels twice as nice because any major prize you win doubles. The cash value doubles. Even our $365,000 super prize doubles.
Twice as rich,
twice as nice.
The Publishers Clearinghouse $2 million sweepstakes is in the mail. So enter. When it comes to winning, there's no place like our house.
Since we made this our Friday show, the Father's Day show, we thought it would be appropriate if one of our fantasy games was designed specifically for the benefit of some of the dads in the audience today. How many dads do we have in the audience? Would you raise your hands? And, well, I'll raise my hand. I'm here in the audience. Okay. We're happy to see that because we also have some children in the audience whose fantasy it is to try and pick out a real nice Father's Day gift for their papas. Now, let's meet the children. And kids, when you hear your names, not only will you come up, just drag your dads with you. Okie doke. Let's meet Stacy Gwillem, Angie Capps, Isaac Cohn, and Nikki Predata. Come on up here, children. My goodness gracious. Here we are. Let me go down here. Are you okay? Can you see? All right. You are Nikki Predata?
Yes.
I'm glad to hear that. I'll be right back. You will excuse me. I'm going to chat with... Boy, are they gorgeous. Hello. I'll start with the tallest. You are 11 years of age, and your name is?
Stacy Gwillem.
Nice to see you, Stacy. Any hobbies?
Yeah. Stickers, and I collect a lot of bears.
Oh, do you?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's nice. My Stefan likes stuffed toys and stuffed bears and stuff
my
like that.
My room's full of it.
And so is Stefan. You must meet sometime. Yes, and you... Beautiful child. First of all, come out here. Let's show this outfit. I'm telling you, look at this outfit. Is this beautiful? Nice to see you. You are?
Angie Capps.
And how old are you, Angie?
9.
Do you have hobbies?
Yes, I like dancing and I bike race.
Well, good for you. Now, if you just get back behind that little podium, I'm, good job, guys. Good job. Hello, Isaac?
Hi.
Can we see Isaac, by the way? We can't see Isaac. Can we see Isaac? Now we can see. This is Isaac Cohn, by the way. Isaac, do you have any hobbies?
I ski.
Really? I'm scared to death to ski. I'm afraid I'm going to break something. How long have you been skiing?
About 3 years.
Get out of here. My rotten kid. Hello. Would you like a box, by the way? You think you can hang in there?
Yeah.
Okay. This is Nikki Predata. What are your hobbies?
Ice skating.
That's it. Well, you certainly are lovely. We have rules here. Before I have the rules, I want to say hello to the dads. You are?
Pedara, Ramon Pedara.
Nice to see you.
Barry Cohen.
Hiya, Barry.
Ron Jones.
Yes?
Richard Gwillem.
Better known as the Four Tops. The four dads. You should be very proud of your children. Lucky guys. Now, since this is a unique fantasy pick-a-gift game designed for Father's Day, the dads will not be allowed to coach the kids, all right? It will be up to each of you children to decide on which gift you would like to have for Dad. And before we show you what different Father's Day gift we have, let me remind you of the rules. Of course, on every show, we have rules. All you have to do is just pick the gift you want for your father, and that gift is his. But if two or more of you choose the same gift, nobody gets that gift. We do a lot of old goshes, and eyes and ears open, because here's Glenn Scarpelli. Do you like Glenn Scarpelli?
Yes.
Yeah, I know. He's going to tell you about each of your possible choices. Glenn, look at that. Wow.
Hey, check this out, huh? Well, first, you might want to try to pick, and this one's for Dad. You might want Dad to get in shape with XL's Brutus Bench, Squat Rack, and Leg Developer. Quality-made exerciser for the home, designed to make exercising a pleasure, furnished by XL. Or how about this Father's Day pick? A set of Pinseeker custom-made golf clubs, including the Bombshell stainless steel woods with matching iron and professional staff bag furnished by Pinseeker. And included in this package will fly your dad and mom to Palm Springs, California. Check it out. For a vacation at historic Ingleside Inn, wonderful dining at Melvin's, dinner and dancing at Cecil's East, then disco at Cecil's West, an elegant vacation in Palm Springs. Or you might just take a chance at this gift package, a beautiful Lazy Boy recline-away recliner. Placed just inches from the wall, this chair is designed to recline with ease, comfort, and quality, furnished by Lazy Boy. Included with the chair will be Dad's very own cordless telephone. Huh? And finally, you just might want to try and pick this extravaganza for work. Dad can sneak a peek at his little portable TV at work, and then at home, he can enjoy the Munts electronic, original, self-contained projection TV with 52-inch screen, infrared remote control, and random channel selection, furnished by Munts Electronics. Good luck, all of you. Have fun.
Right. Well, I was watching the children. Angie was looking. See, they're all in the line here, but they're all juxtaposed. They're not in the same line, and she was looking. She was looking at the golf clubs and the TV and the giant TV and the exercise equipment and the chair and the cordless. Oh, don't tell me. And poor old Isaac, he had problems. Did you see everything, Isaac? You know which way you're going to go, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Well, those are the Father's Day gifts, and good luck to everybody. Don't match up here. I'm going to say pick a gift, then you'll pick a gift. So pick a gift. Okay, what have we got here? No, don't hold it that way. That's good. And what have we here? Huh? What have we here? All right. Now, I'm going to ask you to reveal individually. So I'll start with Stacy. Would you turn it around, and what have you chosen for your daddy? The chair and the cordless phone. Angie, what did you choose? Could you hold that? Oh, the chair and the cordless phone. That's not good. I hate it when it turns out this way. Would you reveal here, Isaac? What have you got? Exercise equipment. Let's see. Well, I don't think he needs it, Isaac. He's in pretty good shape. Now, don't reveal yet. We do not want to see the exercise equipment, and we don't want to see the chair. So, Nikki, would you hold it up real high? What did you... The giant TV goes to the Padada family. Pop Padada. Pop Cohn. You both have terrific gifts. Hey, guys, think of how lucky you are to have this gorgeous lady. Well, for all of the children here who remember their dads on Father's Day, each of them will receive their very own portable stereo system with stereo tape capabilities. And to you guys who didn't get the big gift, it's all Father's Day. We would be remiss if we did not include something. This, after all, is fantasy. So the dads will receive as our consolation gift from you girls to them. Sanyo's cordless extension phone that works up to 700 feet, convenience, freedom, and portability. Happy Father's Day from Fantasy.
Some members of our studio audience and some Fantasy participants will receive Lazy Boy's recline-away recliner, placed just inches from the wall. This chair is designed to recline with ease, comfort, and quality, furnished by Lazy Boy. West Bend's Stir Crazy Automatic Caramel Corn make a fast and easy to use because it stirs itself with great-tasting popcorn, caramel corn, or cheese corn. From across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils, plus this attractive Hawaiian Tropic inflatable raft.
Next, a song from Peter Marshall with a salute to Fathers of America. And then we'll announce the third winner in our weekly drawing for our Have a Fantasy game, coming up next.
The Panadol Discovery.
By Julie's wedding day, was I nervous? What a headache.
And surprise, Bobby got leave from Europe. He saw I was hurting and gave me a pain reliever called Panadol. He discovered it in Europe. It's 1,000 milligrams strong and it won't upset my stomach. I never heard of Panadol, but by the time the guests arrived, my headache was gone. Now Panadol's made here in America.
Discover world-proven Panadol, as strong a pain reliever as you can buy, and it won't upset your stomach.
You've got a choice with Love My Carpet. Because Love My Carpet gives you a choice of four wonderful scents. Citrus Fresh, Floral Fresh, Soft Scent, and Regular. Love My Carpet gets dog, cat, and smoke odors out of the rug. Just sprinkle it on and your whole room smells fresh, clean. And all four Love My Carpet scents keep me smelling fresh. That's why you'll love, love my carpet. Pick them up. I do.
Oh, my kitty cat craves cream.
Every day, cats dream up new ways to make sure they get crave. That's because Crave Dry Cat Food is made with real chicken, real milk, and real tuna proteins. Crave, with the real protein-rich foods cats crave.
My kitty cat craves crave.
Hey, Tommy Lasorda. How do you spell relief?
Raj, I love to eat, but I don't always manage my stomach right. For heartburn, I spell relief R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Wherever I am, for heartburn, it's R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaids really does spell relief.
Like a sponge, Rolaids antacid medicine consumes 100% of the acid required to give millions 100% relief.
With that batting average, it's R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
For millions of Americans, Rolaids spells 100% relief.
Tonight, when the Knight Rider takes on a gang of bikers, the leader's out to get Michael. But will Kit bowl them over in time with its awesome power? Then, can Eyeshide match wits with a psychotic killer before an undercover cop becomes the next victim? It's hot action on Eyeshide tonight.
We're NBC. Just watch us now.
Today is our Father's Day show. And I can't think of a more appropriate person to be in our fantasy spotlight than a man that I know who is a great father, a great stepfather, a great, but not a great grandfather, but he's a terrific grandfather. Ladies and gentlemen, my friend, Peter Marshall.
This is for all the babies. Hope they're watching. You are so beautiful to me. Yeah. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're all I've ever hoped for. You're all I'll ever need. You are so. You are the sunshine of my life. Oh, that's why I'll always be around. You are the apple of my life. Forever you'll be in my heart. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute old. I never thought through love we'd be making one as lovely as she. But isn't she lovely? Made from love. You are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're all I've ever hoped for. You're all I'll ever need. You are so. So beautiful to me. Each and every one of you. My life.
Some members of our studio audience and some fantasy participants received Benchmark's beautiful Saxony carpet made of soil-resistant nylon, available in any decorated colorations furnished by Benchmark Carpet Mills. Golden Grain macaroni and cheddar dinners made with enriched elbow macaroni, creamier cheddar cheese, and other natural flavors from Golden Grain Macaroni Company. Hanes Famous Inspector 12. Make sure that Hanes Men's and Boys underwear gives you comfort, durability, and Hanes dependable quality. Hotel accommodations for some fantasy participants. Furnished by the Burbank Airport Hilton, featuring 14 meeting parlors for 8 to 800, banquets to 500, featuring freshly prepared food, custom tailored menus, and the chef's personalized attention.
And still more to come as the lucky dad in our audience finds he's on his way to Hawaii. And big news, we'll find a lucky winner in the Have a Fantasy game. Don't go away because it might be you.
Is that the Publisher's Clearinghouse $2 million sweepstakes you just got?
Yeah.
How come you haven't sent it in?
Who are you kidding? It's just a big come on.
That's what I used to think until $100,000 cash came into my life.
You never hear if anybody ever wins.
That's what we used to think.
Until we heard we'd won on TV.
You know that Publishers Clearinghouse $2 million sweepstakes you just got? Why haven't you sent it in? Lots of clearinghouse winners used to think that, too. Come on, send it in.
Here's a whole new way to make a dessert. It's Jumbles.
Fudge Jumbles.
New Fudge Jumbles brand dessert mix. A fresh idea from Pillsbury.
Bottom's chewy oatmeal. Middle's moist and fudgy. Topped with oatmeal. It's Jumbles.
Fudge Jumbles.
More than a brownie. Nothing like a cookie. It's Jumbles.
Fudge Jumbles.
Fudge Jumbles. The new dessert idea from Pillsbury.
The freshest ideas are baking.
New Fudge Jumbles.
Baking at Pillsbury.
Lesson number one. Whatever happens, be protected. Exercise. Eat the right foods. Rest. And help protect yourself against iron poor blood with Geritol every day. Iron poor blood is the number one nutritional problem we women have.
But Geritol is iron rich. Great protection against iron poor blood. Iron is Geritol's middle name.
Take Geritol. I do. It's great protection.
Credence, the one that took a stick out of gum.
Stick out of gum.
And puts the fresh in your bread.
Yeah,
Credence, the one that took the stick out of gum.
Stick out of gum.
And puts the fresh in your bread.
Yeah, Credence, the one.
Credence gum not only won't stick to your dental work, it helps clean in between to freshen your breath while you chew.
Credence, the one that took the stick out of gum.
Stick out of gum.
And puts the fresh in your bread.
Credence, the one.
Freshen your breath with non-stick Credence.
Complete rules for the Have a Fantasy game are available by sending a self-addressed stamped envelope to Rules, Post Office Box 64714, Los Angeles, California 90064.
That's right, and we are here to tell you about the Have a Fantasy game, a game in which we'll be giving away some incredible prizes, gifts like a new car, a new boat, cash, thousands of dollars worth of merchandise.
And a new $100,000 fantasy home, three bedrooms, two baths, 1,800 square feet of beauty and efficiency from Domes America Incorporated and its international network of dealers, Willowbrook, Illinois.
If you are 16 years of age or older and live in any of the 50 United States, all you have to do to enter the Have a Fantasy game to win a daily prize, the home, the money for the land, and over $25,000 in additional fantasy gifts is...
To print your name, address, and telephone number legibly on a 3x5 piece of paper or an entry blank available at participating Hardee's restaurant and place it in an envelope and mail it to...
The Have a Fantasy game, P.O. Box 60720, Los Angeles, California 90060. All daily drawing entries must be received by midnight June 23rd, 1983. All entries must be received no later than midnight July 21st, 1983.
Drawings will be held at least once a week, commencing with the fantasy programs, which are scheduled to be broadcast during the weeks of May 30th through June 20th, 1983, and daily thereafter through July 22nd, 1983.
The grand prize entry will be selected on the fantasy program, which is scheduled to air on July 25th, 1983. All entries will be drawn... What, did I say it right? All entries will be drawn at random from a random selection of the entries received. Ta-da!
The first person whose entry is selected in 1983 in each drawing will be notified by telephone within 24 hours of the air date of which the program on which their name is announced.
We have to do this.
If that person is ineligible or cannot be contacted pursuant to the uniform procedures established by the Accord accounting firm of Ernst & Whitney, we will telephone the alternate entry selection.
I don't know.
But the same procedures will be followed until a winner is obtained whose name will be broadcast on Facebook.
Now, right now, Leslie Uggams is outside and ready to draw today's winner. This is the number one. Leslie!
Thank you, Peter. As you can see, it's a little chilly out here, so I put my coat on. Okay, let's see who the winner is. Wonderful. There is no name. I have to open this. Hold on. The winner is Connie Ponche, and she lives in El Dorado, Arkansas. Congratulations, Connie.
Thank you, Leslie, and congratulations to our winner. It's fantasy seat time, though, here in the studio. But since we sort of dedicated the show to Father's Day, We thought we'd do something a little different. We call it a Father's Day fantasy seat. All righty?
Okay, that's right. Rather than just picking a seat number at random, we took all of the blues for the guys, audience fantasy cards that our audience filled out today.
We went through every single one of them and picked out the ones that were dads.
And just from the blue dads cards, we had an NBC representative pick out one of those cards at random.
And that lucky dad is in today's fantasy seat.
And that seat is worth not the usual $500, but a trip for two to Hawaii. Fly you and a friend via Western Airlines spaceship from Los Angeles to Honolulu. The island of service features warm hospitality, delicious cuisine, furnished by Western Airlines for a week's stay at the luxurious Hawaiian Region Hotel on the scenic side of Waikiki Beach near Diamond Head. Fine Hawaiian service furnished by the Hawaiian Region Hotel.
Yeah.
All right, now.
Right.
Hey, guys, you filled them out. We have a winner here. Let's do it with clues. All right,
okay.
Who's got the number one clue?
I got the first one. Okay, this dad has four children.
All right, second clue.
Okay, I've got second clue. His first name is Bob.
Bob with four children.
Okay, third clue is this dad actually wrote that his fantasy was a trip to Hawaii.
Ooh, wow. We got four kids, Bob, and his fantasy was to go to Hawaii.
Right. Now, this person was born in Chicago.
Oh,
Chicago, Bob, does anybody...
Wait. The fifth clue. I got another clue.
Okay.
Okay, he may have been born there, but he's now living in Wisconsin.
Does anybody fit that description? If so, come on up here.
Yeah!
Well, we don't know if this is the winner. Turn around.
We don't know yet.
We have no idea if this is the winner. All I know is if he isn't, I'm not going to mess with him. You are, I hope, Bob.
Hall.
Bob Hall from? Yeah.
Across Wisconsin.
Out here vacationing?
Right.
You know what happens? The happy Father's Day. You and whomever. Who's the whomever?
My wife.
What is her name?
Judy.
Judy, congratulations. Yeah. The two of you are going to Hawaii. Yeah. That's wonderful, really. Thank you.
Hi,
you can stay right here if you want to. You're back.
Yes,
back. We're gonna miss our three girls, aren't we?
That's right.
Our three daughters.
Our three daughters are leaving, but our oldest son, Scoop Scarpelli, is staying with us.
Well, he's gonna be back Monday. All right.
I'm hanging out.
And Monday is a biggie for 10 young men somewhere across the country. We'll be announcing the chosen ones in our search for Fantasy Man. And twins from Texas meet their mother, who put them up for adoption 23 years ago, and their brothers and sisters, whom they've never seen.
Musician Nick Lewin steps into the fantasy spotlight to a real fantasy illusion.
And if you enjoyed our Father's Day tribute, watch the credits at the end of the show for our Father's Fantasy Cruise tribute to their dads.
Oh,
a list of their fathers and staff of our staff members.
Oh, great.
Whoa.
That's great. Whoa. Now, to everyone,
have a good day,
happy Father's Day. And remember, dreams become reality.
Right here.
Happy Father's Day, Daddy.
Made from love. You are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're all I've ever hoped for. You're all I'll ever need. You are so beautiful. You are so beautiful to me.
Each and every one of you, my life.
Monday, Sydney's landlady wants more than just the rent. And on Family Ties, Alex brings home a girl with big ambitions.
I really want to be a cheerleader.
Is she something else or what?
Then meet the most beautiful women in the world. Their bodies are worth millions alive. But someone is killing the world's greatest models.
Nobody bakes a cake as tasty as a tasty cake. Nobody bakes a cake as tasty as a tasty cake.
It's Robinson Summer Sale and Clearance. You'll save 30% on striped cotton knit shirts with the famous alligator logo. Save 45% on colorful cotton beach towels, just $10.99. Save 42 to 60% and more on feather and down pillows, all sizes, just $19.99. And save 31 to 60% and more on Wamsutta No Iron Percale Queen and King Size Sheets and Comforters. The Summer Sale and Clearance, happening now at Robinson's.
In the news at this hour, the chopper pilot involved in that Twilight Zone movie set accident loses his license to fly. The Coast Guard in Long Beach is enlisted in a new war on drugs. I'm Kelly Lang. We'll have details on this and all the news at 4 o'clock.
This is Mary Frances Berry, a member of the United States Civil Rights Commission, who recently was, I don't know about the language here, you weren't fired because the president can't do that. The
president announced we were fired. He announced we were fired, nominated some people to replace us, but until the Senate votes to either replace us or not, we continue to keep on working. We keep on sawing wood, as I put it.
Is there really a constitutional question as to whether or not he has the power to fire you?
Well, there are lawyers who say that he doesn't because the commission is independent, doesn't work for him, reports to the Congress, and that's the way it was set up.
Yeah.
But right now, we want the issue solved politically. We hope the Senate doesn't agree with him and that they understand that we ought to stay there. And in the meanwhile, we'll just keep on working in the cause of civil rights.
Right. Let's take us to school here for just a moment
Okay. Now.
Let's not put the people to sleep, but this is pretty important. What the United States Civil Rights Commission
is... What is it we do? All right. Civil Rights Commission is very simple. Been in existence 25 years, has six people on it.
Mm-hmm.
Bipartisan, three Democrats, three Republicans, okay? What we're supposed to do is to monitor the federal government agencies that you heard about, like Department of Justice and the EEOC and all those agencies, to see if they're enforcing the laws that are on the books that say they ought to protect the rights of women, minorities, the handicapped people, the aged, to see to it that they get access to all those programs that our taxpayers' dollars pay for.
Right.
And in every administration, you know, there are people who, presidents, for example, who like to enforce one law and not another one, or they're not doing enough here and there, and the commission might criticize them.
Okay.
No president's ever tried to fire anybody for criticizing them because they know that that's the job of the commission. Now we have a president who says, hey, you guys keep criticizing us, and besides, the constituency that elected us doesn't like civil rights, therefore we're going to fire you to shut you up and to keep you from monitoring us in the area of civil rights, and we say we don't work for you and we'll just keep on doing our jobs.
Yeah.